For well over a decade, Luamanuvao Dame Winnie Laban has been working hard to get this project off the ground alongside Pacific and business communities, local and central government.
It's actually about identity and acknowledging and celebrating the huge contribution that Pacific people have made to Aotearoa New Zealand.
Last month, government announced funding of $10 million to move the Fale Malae into the next phase of planning and development, to turn this Bunny Street site in central Wellington into what will hopefully stand here in the future. Members of the community welcoming the development.
It is fantastic. It is a dream and from the Pacific people to have a house like this, probably more than 20 years.
This is something that has been really dear to our hearts, and we have been very vocal about our desire for something like this, the Fale, and what it represents.
The corporates will be able to use it, so we'll be able to get some income. The university will be able to use it, so we'll get income from that. But also our community will be able to use it at a very much reduced rate.
Students from Victoria University of Wellington are also excited to have a place to call home.
Not just the students, but the public servants here in New Zealand who are of Pacific descent.
As an international student coming here, the idea of having a fale is really nice. It'll feel like, it'll make us feel like we're at home. It'll feel like we have somewhere to belong to and be ourselves.
It's important to note that this site in which the Fale Malae will sit on is right in the heart of the Parliamentary precinct. Just across the road is the Central Railway Station. Wellington Harbour is no more than 200 metres away, and this site here on Bunny Street is smack bang in the middle of Victoria University's School of Business and Government and Faculty of Law. And of course, in the background, the Beehive.
Wellington City Mayor Andy Foster voted in favour of the project and came down to the site to show his support, but he's aware there is still a lengthy process ahead before building starts.
Because it's a road, so you've got to go through a road stopping process and also a resource consent process. So those are the challenges. As I said, it's not the easiest site because of those two things. But you know, if it can get through those processes, then start digging.
Working alongside Luamanuvao on the Fale Malae Trust Board is Cook Islander Adrian Orr, Governor of the Reserve Bank. He couldn't appear on camera, but in a statement said, the Fale Malae will be an iconic focal point for those with Pacific heritage to gather, learn and celebrate their arts, cultures, histories and futures, providing a pathway for education, commerce and politics. To make sure the Fale Malae comes to life, the board are adamant that Pasifika people be involved at all levels of the project, including design.
We are all of the shared view that this has to have Pasifika architects on board. From the many different Pacific countries that reflect the design knowledge and the heritage in those countries.
The project is forecasted to cost around $35 million. As well as the government's contribution, Victoria University will also contribute $10 million and the trust will fundraise the remaining $15 million.
Naturally, we're going to go to generous people who have money, and then we'll probably do a nationwide or regional, international-wide appeal to Pacific people. And so every dollar will be welcome.
So when can we expect the cutting of a ribbon?
Look, with a fair wind and a lot of good luck, I would hope we'll be cutting a ribbon in 2 to 3 years, but it's very early days. We have to work through the process. But you can rest assured that Luamanuvao Dame Winnie Laban is the wind in our sails, and we will keep moving as fast as we possibly can